time to get up and do life's work. So this video is going to be about covering the cost of my prescription for medical cannabis in New York. But first, I have to reveal my participation in the regulation and the first step in New York State legalizing recreational cannabis. And this is super exciting to participate in and document, because in my next video, and I want you to check below for this, is going to be specifically about me speaking to over 200 people at the listening session in Rochester, New York during the months of September and October of 2018. New York opened up all these listening sessions throughout the state for residents to come and speak, and I took advantage of that opportunity. I'm very excited. So what I had to say at the open forum is in a video. So this cannabis exposing in New York is just transitioning into a brand new focus of getting access to clean cannabis, because I really have uncovered that it is about knowing the ingredients, it's knowing about the sourcing, it's knowing about the love and the gratitude and the relationship with that sacred plant. Because I'm going to be making a whole bunch of new videos about some of the things I've been participating in. And one of them is I've been attending conferences, and the healing power of cannabis is so profound. I'm going to be giving out some of the recipes and some of the products that I use personally, because that's what I'm looking for. This is not about smoking cannabis, though it's a great way, and that's a way we've kind of been utilizing very, very frequently, yet the full spectrum of the plant, the whole plant, and that is some sacred stuff to me. And watching and attending to it and cultivating it and then processing it and utilizing all these methods to be transparent is fundamental. One of the cool things that I do for myself is I utilize full plant matter, and having access to that is very, very hard in a state where it is not open. There is no community going on. So I'm going to be making videos talking about establishing that community and my perspective on that, my relationship with that, yet also the ingredients, because it's impossible when we further our education. And I go to these conferences and I have these opportunities with people all over the country and New York State residents. This one so happened to be in Vermont. It is profound to openly and publicly talk about this plant that has been suppressed for the last 80 years with propaganda. And that's where New York State Medical Cannabis Program has led me to it, with complete disgust, the lack of transparency, the lack of knowing a spectrum analysis and only two compounds, THC and CBD. There are so many forms of CBD, and then THCA, like, we don't have. Get back to the cost. New York State has three products. I only had access to three products with my prescription. My prescription was to get low dosages, and I really wanted a super high CBD. And with my conditions, I'm not going to get into a lot of personal information, was to dose throughout the entire day via the three different methods in order to continuously have my body being exposed to the medicine. And realistically, yes, taking it all day. And again, we started off with small dosage and it cost $800. And what was going on is the vaporization cartridge was $100 for, and that lasted me less than a week. So over the course of the month, that was $400. The ratios of that, it didn't matter if you had high THC or high CBD or a one-to-one ratio, it cost all $100 for their vaporization cartridges. And those were, the size of the vaporization cartridge is only 0.5 milligrams, and that's pretty small. And when we're talking about the other products, the tincture, that was for a week, $54. So again, over the course of the month, $216. But with the tincture, and I was doing high CBD with that, that method of delivery burned. It had alcohol. It was not even exciting when it came that part of the day, because it was just like, ah, this method is kind of horrible. I really wanted to connect with New York in terms of topicals and edibles and being able to have diverse methods for delivery. So this tincture thing was really a no-go from day one. It was very unenjoyable, let alone the high CBD per dosage was 6.3 milligrams. That's not a lot of milligrams when it comes down to it. The last form was the pill, and the pill for the entire month's supply was $188. That was, again, a high CBD, low THC ratio, and the low THC is 0.25 milligrams, so that's like trace amounts of THC in the pill, yet the high CBD, only 5 milligrams. So when we compare the tincture high CBD to the pill high CBD, we're looking at 6.3 in the tincture, 5 milligrams in the pill. That's not a lot for treatment. For many of us having serious illnesses, many of us having debilitating diseases. I mean, New York State only listed so many conditions, and as you, if you've ever followed the program, it's now up to about 15 conditions or so. And I think the bottom line is this, that with only revealing two compounds, the THC CBD, not knowing which plant, whether it's an indica, sativa, hybrid, the different strands, and then most importantly, the other compounds, and there's no spectrum analysis. I mean, New York State on their website will tell you that it's clean and they're testing for insecticides, pesticides, but there's no transparency with that. It's in some little simple statement on a government website. So the bottom line, it was $800 for the month, and I went up front and fronted, you know, a month's prescription, hopefully that was going to be supportive of my system. And what I found was it wasn't clean medicine, and it was very, very low dosages. And for me to up the dosages, I was looking at, you know, upwards in the thousands of dollars a range for what I thought was going to be plant-based medicine, just like I like to utilize with different herbs and essential oils. And knowing how those are processed is vital to it staying plant medicine and being supportive of the human system. So hopefully that was informative. I got a lot of questions about how much does it cost, and I would say it is not cost-effective. Health insurance does not cover this. There's not one health insurance that covers the cost of cannabis in the New York State medical program. Maybe in the future that will change. But for right now, in 2018, I am done with medical cannabis in New York State. And I've exposed the aspects what I'm not really connected with. Maybe some people find some helpful with that, and that's great. But the realization is there is a different consciousness in different parts of the United States on where you're at with education. There is plenty of research and ongoing research, and to stay current, that's why I'm going to continue on my YouTube channel, Wellness Hero. So be subscribed if you are interested in the transformation of cannabis in our country and also locally in New York where I'm at, because it is about creating multiple communities where we have seed exchanges, and there's cooperatives that go on in other states like California and Oregon and Colorado and Washington State, and it's all this separation. And if we can have a digital creation of sharing as well as local creation of sharing. So leave a comment below on where you're at in your process of establishing a relationship with the sacred plant, because that's what I'm here about sharing. And I really feel so positive and uplifting by my engagements in 2018. But one of the ones I want you to check out is my next video, which is going to be about the listening session on what I had to say to New York State about what is most vital. And it was crazy because I do a lot of public speaking, and going there, my heart was racing. And when it actually came down to it, I said something pretty profound and amazing. I'm very happy. But it was the first time I ever came out publicly and made statements about my situation and my relationship building with the sacred plant and what is the most important thing. So as always, my friends, thank you for watching. If you upvote and like, that's how we leave our digital imprint. Stay hydrated and live enthusiastically. Thank you, water. Have blessings on your day. And from my heart center to yours, the ancients used to say, namaste. Woohoo!